Order. The House has resumed. We're on the third reading of the Environment Canterbury Temporary Commissioners and Improved Water Management Bill. When we broke for had the break for the dinner, Dr. Russell Norman was speaking and has 4:20 remaining if he so wishes.
Speaker.
Dr. Russell Norman.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I'm currently speaking on the third reading of the bill that National and ACT are introducing to abolish democracy in Canterbury. It's also the third reading of the bill National and ACT are supporting to undermine water conservation orders in the Canterbury region. I think it's important to realise what this means. Think, for example, about the water conservation order on the Ahuriri River. The cubicle farms, which have been much discussed, the applications for cubicle farms on Killamont Station, relied on accessing water from the Ahuriri River, and it would have been very difficult for those farms to proceed with the water conservation order in place because of the minimum flow regime that the water conservation order imposed. Hence, the passage of this bill tonight, voted by National and ACT, will mean that the Minister can vary the water conservation order on the Ahuriri without going through the proper process, so that the developers in this case, Williamson Holdings, can get access to the water in the Ahuriri River so that they can destroy Killamont Station. As people may well be aware, the Mackenzie has been destroyed recently by massive dairy conversions, loss of tussock country, massive increase in pollution going into the Ahuriri Ram and into the whole Waitaki system. And I think that part of that problem is going to be made worse by the fact that the water conservation order on the Ahuriri River will now be in danger as a result of National and ACT pushing through this bill in the middle of the night. I think it's important to realise as well that the great paradox that we are passing here a bill to abolish democracy in Canterbury, at the same time we're doing it in a way where there is no democratic input. It's quite an extraordinary thing. There is no select committee process. The public have no right to submit into this process. Members of Parliament hadn't even seen this bill until yesterday afternoon, and then after we got this bill in a very short briefing from the Minister, we were given a very short amount of time in which to look over the bill and actually try to figure out what it's on about. Now, the other thing about this bill, when you look at the regulatory impact statement, the Ministry says it has not been able, this is quoting from the regulatory impact statement, it's not been able to fully quantify the risks and costs of the proposal. Well, I'm not surprised. Who could fully quantify the risks and costs of a proposal that's being forced through at such short notice? Now, the other issue that's been, that has arisen in regard to this bill has been the conflict of interest issues. And the Minister of Agriculture, David Carter, has seemed to put out a release in response to some of the claims that have been made, where he confirms all the key facts. He confirms that he does have a farm on the Hurunui. He confirms that currently very little of it is irrigated, so much of it is open for irrigation, though he says that at this stage he has no intention to irrigate. Well, I'm afraid having no intention isn't good enough, because he still has the potential to irrigate it, which is the whole point, which is why there could be a potential conflict of interest and it should be declared. The other thing he confirms is that he did approach those who were trying to apply to the Environment Court for a water conservation order in order to get them to stop doing it. This, of course, very interestingly, is exactly what he denied in a written question that he answered when I asked him whether he had approached the applicants for the water conservation order. He said no in a written question to this House. So I think it's very clear that the conflict of interest claims that have been raised around this bill have actually been vindicated by the facts which Mr. Carter has now put on the table for our convenience, and I'm sure we'll get into it further. Mr. Speaker, this bill is a bill to get rid of democracy. It's a bill to get rid of water conservation orders. It will disenfranchise 400,000 to 500,000 people for the next 3 years. It's an unacceptable bill to the Green Party. We will not be supporting it, and it is shameful that National and ACT are ramming this through under urgency without proper democratic consultation.